Hey friends, when data integration activities fail, it ends up impacting everything downstream. Constant manual monitoring is inefficient, it's time-consuming, and it's just plain boring. Gaurav is here to show us how you can improve your operational productivity by using alerts on data integration events to monitor your Azure Data Factories proactively, today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Gaurav and we're going to talk more about Azure Data Factories. You've got a way to proactively monitor my pipelines with alerts.
Yes, so the volume, variety, and velocity of data has been increasing, right? Which means that the organizations or enterprises have less time to react to events and maybe respond to the failures that happen to the system. So it's very important for them to proactively monitor their data integration workflows, because the manual approaches don't work and they are generally inefficient and time consuming. Mm-hmm. So what we are saying now is that with Data Factory, you can create alerts, and these alerts are integrated first class in Data Factory. Behind the scenes, we are using the Azure alerting infrastructure like every other Azure service, but they're available first class in Data Factory user experience for them to configure so that they can proactively catch those failures in their pipelines and essentially raise those alerts before any failures impact their system downstream or upstream.
That's really nice, because Azure Data Factory is known for its really excellent monitoring and how fast and how clean it is to monitor stuff. This seems like a natural extension to that.
Exactly. So what we have is that if you go to our monitor section now, and if you go to the alerts and metrics section, we have this ability for you to create a new alert rule. So you can go create a new alert and here just provide the name of the alert. Let's say you want to say fail all pipelines. And this is important. Why I say fail all pipelines is because you can think of this as a template for raising alerts on any failures on any pipelines in your data factory, right? So you can say, let's say we want it to be a SEV1 alert.
Okay.
If we add a criteria over here, we want on failed activity runs. And here, I'm able to select different dimensions as well. So I can select an activity name, pipeline name, or failure type. But as I mentioned, that I want this to be a failure across any pipeline in my data factory, right? Because I'm creating kind of a template for raising alerts on any failure. So I won't select any value over here, and I would just say add criteria. And then I can select whether I want on this particular criteria to be, let's say I'm using an existing group, and in this particular group, if I want to raise an email, an SMS, or an Azure app notification, or a voice call to be raised when this alert fires. So,
and those groups are not specific to Azure Data Factory, those are Azure Alert groups.
Exactly right. So like I said, this is all integrated with Azure Alerting, so those are Azure Alert groups that you create. So if you already have one existing for any other Azure service, you'll be able to see that over here as
nice.
Well. Yeah. So let's say I'm going to say I want the email to be sent to me if it fails. Not only that, I want an SMS as well on particular number. I'm not going to give my number, so let's say some weird number that I type over here. So I say add notification, and at that point the action group is added as well. And I say create alert rule, and at that point what we are doing in the system is we are going and creating this particular alert, and it's going to show up in the portal once it is created. So now if any failure happens across any pipelines in your data factory, you will be notified by a phone call with an SMS in your phone. And because I just configured SMS, if I have configured voice as well, I would have got a phone call as well and an email notification. And that email notification looks something like this, where it says that what kind of a rule triggered for what resource. And it has a link to the resource as well. So if you click this, it takes you directly to your resource where you can look at your particular failure and fix it. And essentially, this is us saying that we will be using this. Organizations can improve their operational productivity because all the DevOps guys in their organization can just click this, identify the failure, work with the data integrators to get the pipeline fixed if there's any issue, and then have the things rolling again for their data integration workflows.
Is it primarily a binary thing where it's failures versus success, or might there be like an anomaly that isn't a failure that I would like to know about, but I don't necessarily want to fail and call that a failure?
So right now it is based on the metrics that we publish to Azure Monitor, right? So if we right now publish, as I was showcasing when I was creating the alerts, if I were to go back and show you, So we have these particular metrics on which you can raise alerts.
So there's a lot of things there. It could be a memory thing. I just want to know about it. Maybe I'm actively debugging something and I just want to be notified about a CPU issue or a memory issue. Mm-hmm. Even though things are successful, they might be bumping up against a metric that I'm concerned about.
Yes. And as you're aware, like we in Data Factory team are constantly looking for customer feedback. So if we find any particular metric that customers are interested in, we'll definitely go add it over here so that they can raise alerts on that metric as well.
That's a really great point. One of the things that we've learned over a number of videos that we've done with the Data Factory team and yourself is that you are extremely responsive to feedback. So if you've got an idea for a metric that could then potentially feed into an interesting alert that would help you proactively improve your productivity, definitely let them know. That's important.
Yes, exactly. So we'll be able to add that and you'll be able to raise alerts on that particular metric as well.
Very cool. So this is available today and I've got this. This is just already rolled out.
Yes, so this is all available. Again, we have a blog that's published that talks about this alerting capability. Mm-hmm. Then we have documentation as well that explains step by step on how you can configure these alerts and you can get rolling with that.
Fantastic. You continue to improve all the time. Be sure to subscribe to their blog. They're always adding new features and a lot of great stuff. I am learning all about how to proactively monitor my Azure Data Factory pipelines with alerts today on Azure Friday.